In this tutorial, I'm going to cover some of the basic concepts relating to databases, particularly Microsoft Access databases. A database is a collection of information that is organized so that it can easily be accessed, managed, and updated. Usually in Microsoft Access, that is stored in a single file. Data can be facts about people, events, things, or ideas, and they are an important asset to any organization as data allows companies to make better business decisions after converting it into useful information. And information is data that has been manipulated and processed to make it meaningful. Now, Microsoft Access, it's a relational database management system, or DBMS, that is created by Microsoft to organize, store, and manipulate data, as well as to select and report on data. Now, key components of Access databases or any database are tables, queries, forms, and reports. And we're going to cover all four of those possibly in separate videos here. Tables are database objects that store data organized in an arrangement of columns and rows. Data is stored in tables, and tables are linked together by a common field, usually, and that's what makes the relational databases. The queries retrieve specific data from the table or other queries and displays only the data you specify. Queries allow you to ask questions about the data in your tables. The form is used to enter new records in a table, edit or delete existing records in a table, and display existing records. And then reports summarize the fields and records from a table or query that you specify in an easy-to-read format suitable for printing. So let's get started with Microsoft Access. As soon as you open Microsoft Access, this is what you'll get. So the first thing you need to do is basically give a name to your database. So here, basically, we could give it a name, for example, contracts. And then click on Create. Notice the location where it's going to store it. At this point, let's go through some of the additional features here as to what we see. Very similar to Microsoft Word, we have the file options. Notice compacting and repairing the database, entering a password or encrypting the database with a password. Then under the Home tab, here is just like in other Word and Excel and other Office applications, you have the most commonly used features, in this case for Microsoft Access. Then under the Create, we have different additional options such as creating tables, creating forms, creating reports, and macros, etc. Under External Data, we have the option to import data from Excel, Access, other database management systems such as Microsoft SQL Server or Oracle databases or other Microsoft Access databases, or actually not Access databases but other systems, corporate systems. You can download or import data from a text file, XML files, etc. Under the Database Tools, this is where you can repair the database, you can define the relationship between the tables, and additional functions as well. So notice here on the left-hand side, this is the Datasheet View. This is where the list of tables will be displayed, queries, forms, and reports, all the different database components, along with macros as well. On the right-hand side, this is where the database components will open. This would be, for example, the tables, it'll be the queries, etc. So let's get started with some basic components of a table or a database. Actually, a database is made up of many tables. So before you get started with designing a database, you need to keep in mind some of the principles of what's called normalization. Basically, to put it in plain words, normalization is separating different pieces or grouping different pieces of data together. For example, all the pieces of information about customers, you'd keep them in one table. All the pieces of information, let's say, about contacts, they would be on another table. Then all the pieces of information about the invoices, they would be in another table. So the grouping of that data is usually referred to as normalization, and all the different pieces. Now, what it means by grouping is what we'll put in each field here on the top of each column. How do we define the different fields for the table? So the easiest way, one of the ways, is to actually double click on the top row here and define the specific fields. For example, customer ID. Then you can press tab and then choose the next data type. So in this case, it will be text, for example. And we are going to have their company. Then the next one, it'll be first name, which will be a text field. Next one, last name. As far as the type of field, what this means is that what type of data we are going to store in that specific field of the table. So it can be a text field, it could be numbers that you're going to store in there. For example, how many items did the customer order? Then it can be currency or a date and time. It could be a yes or no. For example, did the customer pay the invoice? Yes or no. You could put a check mark. It could be a looking up and relationship between different components. It could be a memo or rich text. This would be basically writing an explanation or comments about the customer and so on. Or it could be an attachment such as pictures for products and things of that nature, and additional fields as well. So this is one way to enter the field names once you have grouped them together, once you have normalized it. The normalization, it's a science in itself, so I'm just making it simple in this case. So another way to do the design of the table here is to go under view, and notice there are two types of views. This would be the datasheet view. The other way would be to click on the design view. Then we'd give it a name for this table, so we'll call this customers. And then click OK. And then notice we have the fields that we created earlier. They'll show up here under the field name, the data type, and then a description for each field. The description is basically if somebody else is going to work on this database later, because the database can have hundreds of tables linked together, and the description would help the next person working on it in identifying what the table is and what things are linked to other things as well. So let's define here in this table all the different fields that we want to keep track for our customers. So suppose this is for various contracts that you have with various customers. So as far as customers here, we need the customer ID, and this will be an auto number. That means that it's going to increment from one, then the next one is going to be 2, 3, 4. Notice it's not going to allow duplicates, so you don't want two customers with the same number. Then you want to go and state the company. For example, we want to keep track of the company, and in this case it's going to be text that we're going to insert in that field. Notice the field size by default it's 255 characters. In this case, the company field probably would be like 50 characters. And then first name, and then text, data type is text. In this case, again, we can make that, let's say, 40 characters long for the first name. Then we want last name. That's going to be text. And then you can press also F6 to switch to the field size here. And we're going to make that 40 characters as well. And then we press F6 again, and we come to the next field. And then here we're going to put the telephone number. And then the telephone. Notice you cannot have periods or certain types of characters. So in this case, for the telephone, we're going to make it text for now, just to make things easy. And then we're going to make the telephone number 12 characters in this case, so that we could also put in the dashes if we wanted. Additionally, we're going to put a street address. And that's going to be text. Let's leave that at 255 characters. Then we want city. That will make it 40 characters. Actually, we need to spell that correctly. State. Let's make that 30. Zip. Usually you'd make it the right size. Email. And then you could also put other comments and notes and other fields as well. Under description, like we said earlier, we would put in there the description of each field, what they do. For example, here we'd make it the primary key. And I'll cover the primary keys in a little bit here. So once we are done with the design of the table, make sure that when you're designing these tables, make sure you take the time to put the right fields and the right data type, because changing things later is very difficult, especially once you create the forms, once you create reports and queries. So this is the foundation, it's very important here. And at this point, if we double click on it, we have one table. So basically that's how you create a table. And for more information on how to enter data here, basically to enter data, you'd do it through a form to view and change the data. However, you could enter it directly from the table here as well. So that's one way you enter data into that table.